Hello friends, today we discuss about analytical synthesis of four bar mechanism, or you can say that Frödingian equations for analytical synthesis of four bar mechanism. So before derive this equation, I want to discuss about what is the basic difference between analysis and synthesis. Analysis means aims to determine the characteristics like displacement, velocity and acceleration. Whereas synthesis aims to design or creation of a mechanism to produce a desired output motion for a given input motion. So here the length value of link A, B, C and D can be determined, because synthesis of mechanism, that means design or creation of a mechanism to produce a desired output motion for a given input motion. So where are the application of synthesis of mechanism? So application of synthesis of mechanism is in robotics, where we require desired output motion for a given input motion. So in this derivation, here the length values of link A, B, C and D can be determined. So here we consider four bar mechanism A, B, C, D, as shown in figure, in which AB is known as input link and length of the link AB, that is small a. BC is known as coupler link and length of BC, that is small b. DC, that is the output link, and length of link CD, that is small c. And AD, that is the fixed link, and length of AD, that is the small d. Here link AB makes an angle theta with the x-axis. Link BC makes an angle beta with the x-axis. And link CD makes an angle phi with x-axis. So link AB, BC and DC makes angle theta, beta and phi respectively with x-axis. Here the relation between the angles and link lengths may be developed by considering link as a vector. Here consider link AB as a vector. So this is a vector A. Makes an angle theta with x-axis. So there are two components. One is horizontal and second one is vertical. So this is angle adjacent side. So this component is A cos theta. This is angle opposite side. So this component is A sin theta. So consider link AB as a vector. So there is a vector A, makes an angle theta with x-axis. So there are two components. One is horizontal, second one is vertical. Angle adjacent side is always cos. So this component is A cos theta, and angle opposite side, that is sine. So this component is A sin theta. Similarly, considering link BC as a vector. So this is a vector B, makes an angle beta with x-axis. So again, there are two components. One is horizontal, second one is vertical. So this is angle adjacent side. So this component is B cos beta, and this is angle opposite side. So this component is B sin beta. Always remember, makes component always from tail, not head. If this is a vector, this is a head and this is a tail. So always remember, make components always from tail, or you can say that vector is always in tensile direction. Now consider link CD as a vector. So CD as a vector, and this is a vector C, makes an angle phi with x axis. So always make components from tail. So this is a horizontal component and this is a vertical component. If this angle is phi, then this angle is also phi, because there is a z. Now this is angle adjacent side. So this component is C cos phi, and this is angle opposite side, so this component is C sine phi. Now consider link AD as a vector. So there is a vector D along left direction. So here the relation between the angles and link lengths may be developed by considering link as vector. So here we consider link as a vector and make components horizontal component and vertical component. Now draw one another figure including these components. So again we draw four bar mechanism and we show these components. First component is A cos theta, A sin theta. So here we indicate A cos theta and A sin theta. Second component is B cos beta and B sin beta. So again we indicate this in figure, that is B cos beta and B sin beta. Third component is C sin phi and C cos phi. So downward direction C sin phi, left direction C cos phi, and last that is vector D. So here we indicate vector D. For equilibrium of the mechanism, the sum of the components along x-axis and along y-axis must be equal to zero. So first we decide direction. This is positive x-axis, this is negative x-axis. Similarly, upward direction, this is positive y, and downward direction, that is negative y. So first of all, taking the sum of components along x-axis. So along x-axis, that is A cos theta and B cos theta, that is in positive x direction, and C cos phi and D, that is negative x direction. So first of all, taking the sum of components along x-axis. So A cos theta plus B cos beta minus C cos phi minus D is equal to zero. So subject B cos beta, so B cos beta is equal to C cos phi plus D minus A cos theta. So our equation is B cos beta is equal to C cos phi plus D minus A cos theta, equation number 1. Similarly, the sum of components along y-axis must be equal to 0. So here A sin theta and B sin beta, that is along positive y direction, and C sin phi, that is negative y direction. So taking the sum of the components along y-axis, so A sin theta plus B sin beta minus C sin phi is equal to 0. Again, subject B sin beta, so B sin beta is equal to C sin phi minus A sin theta, that is equation number 2. Next step is squaring and add equation number 1 and 2. So here B cos beta square, that is B square cos square beta, B sin beta square, that is B square sin square beta. Squaring and adding equation number 1 and 2. So here B square cos square beta plus B square sin square beta is equal to C cos phi plus D minus A cos theta whole square plus C sin phi minus A sin theta whole square. So what is the equation of A plus B plus C whole square? That is A square plus B square plus C square plus 2AB plus 2BC plus 2AC. Similarly, C cos phi plus D minus A cos theta whole square. That is C square cos square phi plus D square plus A square cos square theta plus 2CD cos phi minus 2AD cos theta. Again, plus minus minus, that is minus 2ac cos phi cos theta. So our equation is c square cos square phi plus d square plus a square cos square theta plus 2cd cos phi minus 2ad cos theta minus 2ac cos phi cos theta. Similarly, what is the equation of a minus b whole square? That is a square plus b square minus 2ab. So c sin phi minus a sin theta whole square, that is c square sin square phi plus a square sin square theta minus 2ac sin phi sin theta. Our next step is cos square beta plus sin square beta, that is 1. So here we write b square. Similarly, c square common, so c square common, so cos square phi plus sin square phi. Similarly here a square common, so sin square theta plus cos square theta. Remaining step as it is. So here b square is equal to c square cos square phi plus sin square phi plus d square plus a square common cos square theta plus sin square theta. Remaining step as it is. So b square is equal to cos square phi plus sin square phi, that is 1. So c square plus d square square plus a square. Again, cos square theta plus sin square theta, that is 1. So a square into 1, that is a square. Remaining step as it is. In our next step, minus 2ac cos phi cos theta plus sin phi into sin theta equal to case side aayenge, so plus. So 2ac cos phi cos theta plus sin phi sin theta is equal to a square. B square equal to case side aayega, to minus. So a square minus b square plus c square plus d square plus 2cd cos phi minus 2ad cos theta. Now divide this equation by 2ac. So cos phi cos theta plus sin phi sin theta is equal to a square minus b square plus c square plus d square divided by 2ac plus 2cd by 2ac cos phi minus 2ad divided by 2ac cos theta. Next step, 2 cut, cc cut, so d by a remaining. Here 2 cut, a cut, so d by c remaining. So here cos phi cos theta plus sin phi sin theta, that's equation is cos phi minus theta is equal to a square minus b square plus c square plus d square divided by 2ac. Here remaining d by a, so d by a cos phi. Here remaining d by c, so minus d by c cos theta. We know that cos minus theta is equal to cos theta. So here we can write, instead of cos phi minus theta, here we can write cos theta minus phi. So cos theta minus phi is equal to k1 cos phi minus k2 cos theta plus k3. Here length of the links never change. Here what is the meaning of ABCD? That is the length of the links. So length of the links is constant. So here length of the links constant, only variable that is phi and theta. So d by a, that is we assume constant k1. So k1 cos phi, d by c, here we assume k2, so minus k2 cos theta, plus here all are constant, that is k3. Either value of a or d can be assumed to get proportionate value of other parameters. So Fruhrensen equation, that is cos theta minus phi is equal to k1 cos phi minus k2 cos theta plus k3, where k1 is equal to d by a, k2 is equal to d by c, and k3 is equal to a square minus b square plus c square plus d square by 2ac. So this equation is known as Fruhrensen equation. Thank you.